So now this is a very particular interview because, like I said, he is a gospel dancehall reggae artist. We don't get many artists like yourself on the show. So I know that you didn't originally start as a gospel reggae artist. So tell us about, you know, the beginning stages of Marshall One, or, you know, just tell me how you started.
United States, came from Jamaica, and after high school, we grow in the dance hall. It was something I love. It goes on in the neighborhood, you know. And we DJ, sound system, in the basement, and the little corner stores and the clubs in the neighborhood. And then we little by little, it's a love. When you love something, you know, you're gonna follow it, you know. So that's why I was just out there, and that's how we meet up with all the other artists like Screechy Don, Red Fox, Raven, Shaggy, Flighty Wonder, Carpenter Town. I could just go on.
Oh, wow.
Sleepy Wonder, all of us. So, you know, this time when shows would go on from Biltmore Ballroom Church, I mean, Starlight Ballroom, Galaxy, all over Brooklyn, Crown Nights, it's just us. And then we start taking it locally. And that's where I was, you know. And I did my song back in 1987. I did She Turned Me On and Witty Label for Music Master. And that did great with Trevor Sparks. His song was On the Wings of Love. So both was on the same beat. We were rocking, you know what I mean? So I traveled and toured locally in the United States,
Okay, you sound busy. So from that, you know, you had your single She Turned. Do you want to give a little something for that?
Well, I mean, you know, like I said, She Turned Me On. Every little thing she do, she turn me on from a little down. Every little thing she do, she turn me on. I love the way she walk and she wind her bottom. I love her sexy finger.
Okay.
Anyway, from I did that, you know, I travel on that. But then I did another song for Epic's record with Philip Smart. And that was Love Is the Message, me and Sammy Levi. And I traveled to England, Scotland, places like that, in London. And we toured on that for like a little bit. That was like 1990. And after that, you know, with my experience and the road is tough, so just a lot I was going through, and I just got off the road just like that. Boom. Just went home, started going to school, college, started going to church. Got saved, baptized, stay in church, read my Bible, loving God. Then after 3 years, like 1993, I started coming back.
Okay, so you didn't let the music totally go after being saved.
No, I just put it on pause.
I mean, that's a good thing. I mean,
put a dimmer switch.
I mean, it happens. Some people, you know, like Mace, he used to do rap and stuff, and then he went and became. So I understand what's going on. He didn't put it on hold forever, you know.
You just turn it down, you know.
That's a good thing, though. Yeah. Praise God.
Because, you know, it's like when you're out here, it's just, you get so much beat up. All different kind of angles of relationship, because this whole thing is relationship. Anywhere from between a man and a woman and a man with businesses, you get beat up, people treat you wrong, you're just tired of it. Like, yo, get off my back, give me a break. So, you know, I got to just rewind, sit back, think about things, get to know who I am, and look for God. Because you want to know God, who your creator, you know what I'm saying? You should be lost in the middle of a dogfight. You know what I mean? And some people win, some people lose. I guess I must be the losing one. I just get out.
You're not losing. You're still alive.
No, I won, but I got out. Try to make them look what they're doing, and I step through.
Because the music industry, you can get caught up in there and lose your way.
There you go.
Definitely.
I saw that. So that's why I come back and release my album back in 1998, Reconciliation. It's a gospel. So I produced the whole thing, released it. You know what I mean?
Okay.
And that's where I keep feeling the whole market. And so I come back out. That's 2002. You know, I got married, got my kids and stuff like that. And just keep going on up until this point. You know, still doing it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
That's good.
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody was on that 1989.
You know, I want to get in there and figure out, you know, what happened. How was your relationship? You know, being that he's mainstream now, what happened? You know, I don't want to throw no shade towards Shaggy, but, you know, we want the scoop.
Yeah, okay, well, with Shaggy, you know, we're all in the New York. We're New York artists, and, you know, right in the time where I, like, left the music for a little while, you know, the Shaggy, Screechy Dan, Raven, Red Fox, Knight Rider, Trevor Sparks, Sleepy Wonder, all of them, they were still doing their thing. So, you know what I mean? I got off the scene a little bit, so that's when I heard about Shaggy and them, they got a little break. Because I met Robert Livingston back when I was in England, and he took my information, he wanted to work with me. But when I came back, we didn't keep the link. But yeah, he put a collaboration virus artist in New York, and Shaggy's song got bust, you know, Caroline and a couple more songs. And he was doing good, and so did Raven and them. So they were doing good. Shaggy just grew bigger and bigger and bigger. You know what I mean? And then, you know, I'm still out there doing my thing. Every now and then I run into him when he do a new release. You know what I mean? We hail up each other, still know me. But, you know, sometimes, you know, I'm just saying them as artists, they grow bigger. Sometimes you feel as if we should get a little bit of hype from him. Should have reached back out and give us an album with him and we could mix. You know, so we could get some little bit because he's big now. Got big money now, you know what I mean? But, you know, I guess they don't have that vision, so they just keep doing what they want to do. You know what I mean?
It's unfortunate, and, you know, if I was an artist and I had a friend who was an artist and we was doing stuff together and they got big, I'd expect a little something, a little help, you know, somehow, some way. But, you know.
Yeah, but, you know, he's doing good. They grow, you know, one stage to another. You know what I mean? I'm always bigging them up, you know what I mean? Big up Raven, Red Fox, all of them. So, you know, that's the way the music industry is in New York, where, you know, we're one family, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And if one get big, we pull each other. But, you know what I mean? Unfortunately, it's not like that all the time.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, always give my respect, due respect, Shaggy, Screechy Dan, all of them. Pac-Man. Mystery. It's a mystery. Big him up. But we're still there doing our thing, man. We love it. We're young, fresh, got nice lyrics, you know what I mean? Jamaica is Jamaica, that's one thing.
Mm-hmm.
They do their song out of Jamaica. We in New York, we do our song here. In London, England, same thing, you know what I'm saying? But that's how we do it in New York, you know what I mean? We're original, fresh, got nice lyrics. But I'm a gospel artist and I stay big up Jesus Christ as Lord all the time.
Amen to that. What about Knock Knock? Tell me about, you know, the singles that you have.
Okay.
That.
So this one here, I have an EP with four songs on it. I was intended at first to put out like 15 track to songs, and I call it Knock Knock because it's one song on it that I loved, and this one we were pushing. I said, when God come knocking at your door, when He come ringing your bell, do yourself a favor, wanna let him in, wanna let him in. Say once upon a time when me never live right, my bad like a yas, bad like a termite. have a hot temper when me get top tight. Me make pay trouble and get in a no fight. Policeman call me and my friend feel the sight. I when I go a no jail fi go me go. Cha! Alright then.
Very nice.
Well, that's one we call knock knock, because we say when God's come knocking at your door. Mm-hmm. And that's what I was doing. But then we kind of make some changes. Me and my manager, and we sit down and say we're going to just put out four. Make an EP, so that's what we've been doing, you know what I'm saying?
Give people a little tease.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Big project.
And just work it like that. So that's the direction we took. So on this one, you can get this on, it's available on YouTube, CD Baby, Amazon. And one of the songs is titled Come Look to God. And then another one called The Bible. The other one is God Became One of Us. Then I have another one that Man Is Dust, featuring Ed Robinson and Tilly Bang.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, The Bible, that's an interesting title. How do you make a song, you know, titled The Bible?
Okay, so, very interesting, but it's something that I understand where I was coming from, my viewpoint, where I grew up in a Rastafarian home.
Mm-hmm.
My father, Rastafarian, you know, we heard about Selassie.
Yeah.
But then, you know, you grow up with grandparents who talks about Jesus. You got churches down here, church on the block,
exactly.
Church over here. So we grew up hearing Jesus died for all mankind, and he's a king. And then my father, Rastafarian, and he teaches us, and I grew up teaching me how to read the scriptures and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And he had the same, it's a mixture of Christianity. But then, you know, when I come to understand for my own and start reading it, that's where I start pulling that lyrics from.
Mm-hmm.
And I start talking about the Bible.
Okay.
The Bible. I'm going to give you a piece. The Holy Bible. Somebody said, the Bible never tell no lie. No. So the Bible never tell no lie. So I believe everything said about the prophesy. That Jesus Christ for all mankind, he died. Okay. So basically, is the information that what the Bible teaches.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm pulling it out. And basically singing it on the songs, on the verses.
Okay.
Yeah, so just tell you the B-I-B-L-E, basic instruction before leaving Earth. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Yeah.
For those who don't know, Bible, basic
instruction before leaving Earth.
So being that you started before just doing regular dance hall, have you got any slap because, you know, you changed from doing regular dance hall to now doing gospel? Like, what's the difference? Like, have you experienced any shade from people? Do people treat you different? You know, any experience that you've got?
Yes, in some way, like with few, like with the colleagues, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But like, because I stayed away probably for a little while, mm-hmm. and able to build myself and build a momentum and come back in and flow.
Mm-hmm.
So when I was flowing among my colleagues, they appreciated it because they knew the way I was.
Yeah.
Before I really, because you know, all that vulgar talk and that nasty, yell, cut up your leg. I did some of it, but mm-hmm. It wasn't my forte. When I go to the studio and they tell me the producer asked me to give him a song, one of the first things is something positive. Because
mm-hmm.
I never forget back in 1987, when I first went to the studio with Witty. He was the producer.
Mm-hmm.
And I did the song, Badness. We're talking about badness and trying to discourage guys with guns mm-hmm. and killing people. So I was saying badness, I kill them. Badness, I madness. Put down the badness. It's foolishness. So he said, come on here, come on here, come on. He didn't want to hear that. So I said, okay, hey, Carpenter, man, I met this girl. I know she's going to be mine. Everything she do, she turned me out. And they go, yeah. So you see what they promote me?
Uh-huh.
So I can't get to do the songs I really love.
Exactly.
Doing. I got to do what they want.
That helps a lot of people.
So that's how the market is. The market is, you want to make money, you want to get popular, you got to sing them ragged tag, nasty song. Yeah, you know, tan, bobby, top, pan. You know?
I don't know where the music has gone, but it's not heading in a good direction.
Yeah, but well, that's what it is. That's the old ghetto market, you know what I mean? Underground. And, you know, they're getting a little hype. But some of them got hype, they ain't getting no money.
Yeah.
To keep. They get hype. I mean, Cartel, when you go and check them out, they was getting a lot of hype. They were making the money. And so, you know, you can see the trend. Some of them get clicked right in where they're making money, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, but that's the good thing about being independent, you know, you get to do
what
you want to do, focus on your own stuff.
Yeah.
So that's a very positive direction.
As long as there's life, we know there is hope. We found a way to survive. We on your nerves, and them do you things where you just don't deserve. One day the world's a blessing, no backers. One day the last will be the first. Full speed forward, you just can't reverse. Uplift yourself when them expect the worst. Hear what me say in a diverse. It's time to leave, time to quench your spiritual thirst. Put on the trouble then you walk away. You don't have to fight today. No, you not we do it again, no do it again. We do it from way back when. Put on the trouble then you walk away. You don't have to fight today. No, you know we do it again, no do it again. We do it from way back when. Put on the trouble, beg your wife from them. Trouble making people take no talk from them. New life, new chapter, new time, my friend. You won't follow your instinct, you just can't pretend. A brand new start, you will find again. Now make nobody interrupt you this time again. One piece of mind, clear mind again. Everything in kind again, love it just shine again. Put on the trouble then you walk away. You don't have to fight today. No, you know we do it again, no do it again. We do it from way back when. Put on the trouble then you walk away. You don't have to fight today. No, you know we do it again, no do it again. We do it from way back when. Me not tell you to take this honor. I feel your life, you can do what you wanna. But if you draw for the guns and the ammo, next thing me know you a go draw for the bomber. Yeah. Take a check and sort out your grammar. Sentence not right, boy, you need a few comma. But if you don't stop talk and stammer, then you will be talking in front of your honor. Whoa. Put on the trouble then you walk away. You don't have to fight today. No, you know we do it again, no do it again. We do it from way back when. Put on the trouble then you walk away. Up on your nerves, and them do you things where you just don't deserve. One tell the world a blessing, no backers. One day the last will be the first. Full speed forward, you just can't reverse. Uplift yourself when them expect the worst. Hear what me say in a diverse. It's time to leave, time to quench your spiritual thirst. Put on the trouble then you walk away. You don't have to fight today. No, you know we do it again, no do it again. We do it from way back when. Put on the trouble then you walk away. You don't have to fight today. No, you know we do it again, no do it again. We do it from way back when.
As long as there's life, we know there is hope. We found a way to survive. We still are traveling on the road. And we can now decide to find a way out to go. The journey's long and it's right. Cause time is longer than the road.
So we say now, the B-I-B-L-E, basic instruction before leaving Earth. So don't leave Earth with it. Sing, I say, the Bible, oh, the Holy Bible. So the Bible never tells no lie, no. So the Bible never tell no lie, no, no. The book can never tell no lie, no. So the Bible never tell no lie. I believe everything that the Bible prophesied. That Jesus Christ for all mankind, he died, resurrected from the dead and exalted and high, at the right hand of the Father, interceding for you and I. You who hunger and thirst, he will satisfy. Trust and believe on him, and upon him you must rely. All of your wants and your needs he'll supply. We are talking about the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ the Most High. The Bible, hey, hey. The Holy Bible, wanna wave it with your hand. The Bible, whoa, the Holy Bible. Yeah, I believe everything that Jesus prophesied. That false prophet shall come in disguise. A wolf in sheep clothing. I hope you are gonna know them. Hey, the Bible.
If someone came to you with the perfect deal, a certain amount of money, for you to do not gospel but just regular dance hall, that raunchiness.
Yeah.
Do you think you'd do it?
Nah. No, with the raunchy, I ain't bother with it. It's because I do gospel,
mm-hmm.
and some of my songs, it's not different specifically. I always saying Jesus in all my songs, because as a reggae artist, you're able to be, you know, adaptable. Like particular one song that I sing, I'm talking about Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
Coming to Jamaica now,
that's
my heritage. You know, that's not negative. There's people in the Bible who talks about their heritage. They talk about their genealogy. He's from Israelite and stuff like that. So I'm talking about my sweet Jamaica, the land where I born, and Yaman Banana, Aki and Saltfish. That's okay. A gospel artist could sing that. But if you buy my album, you're going to hear a full cover. I'm talking about Jesus. I'm bigging up God. That's my soul heart. And then I'll talk about my heritage. I might talk about Brooklyn is where we from. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Bed-Stuy, Cronites, all around, Barkites. We just big up the neighborhood. Yeah, that's what I do. You know what I mean? So it's not negative about that. I'm a kingdom man. I come with Jesus Christ as Lord. He died for my sins. But then I could talk about kingdom things, kingdom principles. You know what I mean? How we live, how we flow.
I get it. I respect that.
Yeah.
Now, you've been to England, you're touring. How is your music accepted, you know, outside of Brooklyn, outside of New York?
Well, so far with the gospel, I didn't gone too way far yet. It's a little bit, you know, from over, like the internet, network, people got my music and I get feedback. And they like it, you know what I'm saying? But this is where I'm like working from right now and speed, because it's a small group. I'm having my manager and me, and it's a small group, so little by little it's trickling, you know what I mean? So the fire start, a little fire, and then it grows in a bonfire.
Yes, it you have to start off small, and then you find your way.
And we hope that we meet people.
So I just want to talk about, you know, you were doing secular music before, and you were doing your tours, but now doing the gospel, you know, it's pretty local. Do you feel like it's moving backwards, or you're just starting a new, you know, just explain how you feel about that.
Okay, well, okay, so with the, once I start doing gospel, I actually like start over,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? So it's a different avenue, it's not the same market. So I'm building from within the church. And Christian people love what I do.
Okay.
But then the style of song and what my mission is, I'm not really singing to Christian, really. I'm singing to the sinners. Because some of my songs, the way I write my songs, is telling the sinner. Because I have one of my songs I have was, if you believe in Jesus Christ, you'll never be the same again. I say, who accept Christ as Lord and Savior, you'll never be the same. Again, so that's not for a Christian. He already passed that stage.
Yeah.
I'm talking about a person who haven't received Jesus. So most of my song is geared towards a sinner. So that's why I don't want to stay in the church with this. I want to go outside in the world. So with my music, it doesn't really bring me back from where I was. It's just that it's a different avenue. It's a different road, the reggae, hardcore, dancehall. It's a different neighborhood. In the gospel now, it's a different neighborhood.
I got it. It's just, you know, a different experience, and you're going to move forward with it.
Yeah, it's still reggae, you know?
You're happy. This is what you want to do.
Yes, I'm happy. And you know what? If I never get popular like a Shaggy or a Michael Jackson,
mm-hmm.
I'm good. I'm enjoying what I do. I'm not looking fame. I'm just looking to big up Jesus' name.
He's
already famous. So
exactly.
He's already famous. Shaggy can't get bigger than that. Michael Jackson can't get bigger. The Beatles can't get bigger than that.
Very true.
Not even Bob Marley can come close to that. Jesus' name is the biggest name above all names. Bigo.
Where can we find your music?
You can find my songs, downloads, available on CDBaby.com, Amazon, iTunes, all of them. I got the EP, 4 songs on it.
Knock Knock.
Yeah.
Go take a listen to that.
Yeah, and the other one I released in September called Coming to Jamaica. Coming to Jamaica now. A long time I haven't seen you. I say Jamaica, Jamaica. You can go on YouTube and catch it. Just put in Marshall 1, Coming to Jamaica. It's available on CD Baby too.
Well, thank you so much for chatting with us.
Yeah.
It was fun, and I respect the path that you're going down.
Thank you very much. All right.
The music with energy. Yeah. Come chat with me, TV. As always saying, come chat with me, TV. Hey, come chat with me, TV. Make you see, we gone globally, internationally. We are going to bring the good information, make people hear and see. Hey, all the way from New York City. We come and tell them, come chat with me, TV. Yay, come chat with me, TV. We got the energy, we got the information for you, so you can see. Yo, we are big up God, the Almighty, Jesus Christ. Whoa, whoa, reality, we attack. Come chat with me, TV. Hey, 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 come chat with me, TV. Can you see me? I see you. What we are gonna do when you come down the neighborhood and down the avenue? You are gonna knock on the door and we are gonna show you what we are gonna do. Come chat with me, TV. Bye, come chat with me. Boom! All of the crew, big up. We're loving the same way. Come chat with me, TV. Yeah.
Now we're gonna take you up on a different dimension. Can you see the song I just do? Play me real low. The song I just do. Them one them I call BC, which means before Christ. That one them I call AD, after Christ. After my conversion, I step to that one and to the plate. I say, all right, God, I'm gonna give it to you all the way. Turn it up, turn it up. And give it to me from the top. Yeah, vibes one cool. You know me, I say, Karen. Yeah. I say, when Almighty God come knocking at your door, what you do?
Yeah.
Oh Lord. Oh Lord. Give it up. I say that when Jah come knocking at your door, when he come ringing your bell, do yourself a favor. Go on and let him in. Go on and let him in. As we say, when God come knocking at your door, when he come ringing your bell, do yourself a favor. Go on and let him in. Go on and let him in. Say, once upon a time, me never used to live right. Me bad like a yas, but like a termite. Me have a hot temper when me get up tight. Me make peer trouble and get in enough fight. Me bust up boy face with all iron pipe. Say, a baseball bat and put out boy light. In a boy got away, me leave my ratchet knife. Policeman come me and my friend flee the site. Come in and go on no jail fi go spend no night. Now go on no courthouse fi get indict. But now me thank the Almighty that me see the light. Come me in a me a Jesus you invite. So me say Jah come knocking at your door. When he come ringing your door, come on do yourself a favor. Go on and let him in. Let him sing with me. God come knocking at your door. We keep on ringing your bell. Do yourself a favor.
Simply Kills.